Hi everyone, welcome to today's class. Today we're going to see business marketing unit 4. Okay, the first we're going to see industrial products are goods. These are the products which are using in industrial. Okay, this is the product and goods. Before that, we have to know what is industrial product or goods. So meaning is it is exciting the customer products, okay, but the industrial products markets often significant in a term of market size. Okay, the industrial products means the materials, capital items, supplies and services, the raw material components, so mostly sold to other industrial users. So these are the industrial products. So mainly the marketing mix of industrial product is quite different from the consumer products due to the features of selling business to business. And the next one is types of industrial products. So what are the types? Based on see this, the material and the parts. Okay. And then second one, capital items. Third one, supplies and services. So by this, the first one, material means some material without that are raw material components. Without the raw materials, we can't make a full product. So output of the product. So based on this, they need raw materials, components, and mostly sold to other industrial users. And for this, price, service key issues, okay. For capital items, the industrial products used in a production or operations. So example, IT system, buildings, infrastructures. And third one, supplies and services. So which operating supplies? So operating supplies means they need energy, manpower, machines, okay. And business services, example of maintenance and security. The next which we're going to see is industrial products and goods under this. What are industrial goods? So what is industrial goods? They need to know. So by this, this is the goods purchased for industrial business or used as known as industrial goods. So the industrial goods will fall under the following categories. The categories are follows. The first one is installations. So for the, if they want to make a product means they need a machinery. So for that, they have to install the machinery first. The second one is accessories. Accessories means to install, to operate the machine. To start a machine, they need a power generator. So for this, second one is accessory. Third one is raw materials. So after the raw materials, they will make a full products. Okay, for that, they need a raw materials like a cotton. Cotton means a type of cloth. Okay, excuse me. If you need a full product is a cloth means you need a raw materials like a cotton. So then fourth one is manufactured parts. So manufactured parts means radiator, battery, etc. So this is needed by a car manufacturer. And fifth one finally, supplies or consumables. So supplies or consumable means lubricants, oils, etc. So these are the industrial goods types. Okay, installation, accessories. First they have to install the machinery. To operate the machinery, they need a power generator. The third one is raw material. Fourth one is manufactured parts. Fifth one, supplies or consumables. Then next we're going to see is types of the buyers. So what are the types of buyer? So types of buyers mainly known as those who buy the components. So why it is those who buy the components means those who buy the components, they will call the buyers. Okay. Then those who buy and install a machine. So those who buy a components, they are buyers. Those who buy and install the machines from us. Okay. If they bought a machine from us means he is also buyer. And those who buy for resale, for second hand. Okay. First, if you are selling a product, some wholesaler retailers, they will get the products of from the manufacturer. After that only they will sell to the customers. So this is those who buy for a resale. The next which we're going to see is characteristics of industrial products or goods. The first one is heavy investment in industrial goods. So why it is heavy investment means the production of industrial goods calls for a heavy capital investment. So most of the companies involved in the production of industrial goods raise capital by issuing a shares and debentures and also by resorting to borrowing from a financial institutions. So this. The second one is a complex nature of products. Though complex nature means this industrial goods always appear,
to be complex in view of their technical nature. So it is not possible for the assess to value of such goods. So one has to have a technical knowledge to be able to access them. And third one is derived demand for industrial goods. Derived demand is, if the demand for industrial goods are derived, it is influenced by the demand for the goods they help to manufacture. So for example, the demand for a soft drink making plan will be determined by the demand for soft drink. The next one is limited number of buyers. So limited number of buyers means when compared to the consumer and agriculture goods. So the number of the buyers of industrial goods is limited. Such buyers are also found in certain regions. For example, most of the buyers of a machine needed for a making cotton cloth are found in around Coimbatore in Tamil Nadu. So for this Tirupur, right? Okay. The next one is inelastic demand. So which means the demand for industrial goods is relatively inelastic. So it is not affected by changes in a price. Then the next one is buying is always a group process. So purchase of consumers or a regular goods can be taken by an individual. But in a case of industrial goods, a group or a team is generally involved in purchases. So the team may consist of engineers, financial experts and others. The next one is higher purchase value of industrial goods. So as industrial goods are very highly priced, each purchase involves in a very high amount. So this is the contrast to consumers and agricultural goods, where the amount involved in each purchase is much less. The next one is after sale service in industrial goods. So this is something which is always important in the marketing of industrial goods. So the seller must ensure regular repair and maintenance service to the buyers. And the next one, seller reputations. So this seller reputation is generally not important in the market of agricultural goods. So it is important to a certain extent in the market for a consumer goods, particularly in the case of durable goods. The reputation of the seller is vital in the case of industrial goods. The buyer would always prefer to buy from reputed suppliers rather than from unknown sources. And the next one is leasing. And the next one is leasing. So another peculiar feature of the industrial goods marketing is that lease. So seller may enter into the leasing agreement with the user instead of making an outright sale of machinery. So this does not apply to consumer goods. Sorry for the side noises, please ignore that. And the next one is rational and not emotional buying. So in this case, the consumer goods, the buying decision is influenced by the status, prestige and such as the emotional factors. So the buyer of industrial goods, on the other hand, makes an objective analysis of the unity of the product before taking the purchase decision. Next one is greater awareness of the buyers. So by this is greater mean the buyer of a consumer goods may not have absolute knowledge of the goods they buy. So they adopt a casual approach to buying. On the other hand, the buyers of industrial goods have true knowledge of the product, its source of supply, the alternative models available, so the price of the competing models, etc. And finally, shorter channel of distribution. So which means the marketers of industrial goods usually supply the goods directly to the customers. So wholesale, retailers and others who work actively in the consumers and agriculture goods markets are generally absent in the market for industrial goods. So the marketers of industrial goods resort to direct supply mainly because of the number of buyers is less, and such buyers are also found in certain regions only.
And the next which we're gonna see is product strategy. So product strategy means it is a high-level plan describing what a business hopes for accomplish with its product and how it plans to do so. So this strategy should answer key questions such as who the product will serve, persons, how it will benefit those persons, what are the company's goals for the product throughout its cycles. And the next one is importance of product strategy. So the So mainly the importance means it is a serve several valuable business purposes. So it provides a clarity for your company.
So your team will be the better position to deliver their best work when you draft, communicate a clear, well-thought product strategy to your communications. So your developers will understand how the product of the product that they are working on contributes to the larger strategic goals. So in your marketing, sales teams will be able to the product's benefits and unique selling proposition. Your customer success team will better understand your product's use and cases, therefore provide a better support for your users' frustration. So it helps to prioritize your product roadmap after you have earned stakeholder agreement for your proposal. So it will be time to translate the strategy into the high level of actions. The next, which we are going to see, developing product strategy for existing products. So to develop the long-term product strategies for existing individual products, they need following tools. The first one is product evaluation matrix. So which means, which evaluate a product's performance of all the existing product or a product lines using the techniques. The second one, perceptual mapping technique. So it is an examine of relative selecting, okay, relative strength and weakness of the products and company's products when comparing with the competitors. The third one is based on the above two analysis, decide product strategy. Based on the above means the above from product evaluation and perceptual mapping. So based on these two, this analysis will be decide the product strategy. So these are this, whether for the decide product strategy means whether to continue, whether to modify, whether to eliminate or drop the products, or whether to add a new product line. So these are the things they will follow under product evaluation and perceptual mapping. That's what I said, whether to continue, whether to modify, whether to eliminate or drop product, and whether to add a new product or product line. So by this, we're going to see products elimination. So what is product elimination means? These are some conditions which apply for the product. If the product will not go as their wish of the company, then they will eliminate the products or drop the products ideas. Okay. So by this, the meaning means if the all company decides to eliminate the products or product line, then the following factors need to be considered. The factors which are following means, so mainly it is the meaning of, it is a decision to drop a product from the portfolio on its poor market performance. So the market demand for the such products has been dipped into the none, and hence product elimination or closer to is carried out. Based on this, what are the needs to be carried out to know the product's elimination means? Will the consumer relationship be affected? If they are dropped the product, will the consumer will affect that? They have to find. And will the profitability affect due to the change in overhead, fixed cost, okay, allocation? If it is yes, they need to discuss about that. And third one, what will be the reaction of the employee? Once they have decided to stop the product means the employee's work will be not in scheduled. So they will be affected by them salary. So that they have to find the reaction of the employee too. And then fourth one, will the sales of the other products be affected? We have to check that. So if we dropping only one products within the company means it will not affect. If we dropping more products, it will affect the sales too. If sales drop, no profit will be found. Is there a new product to replace eliminate products? For example, if they are selling a bar and liquid soap, okay, the same thing for washing, okay. If bar soap is not working well, means they will shift. If the liquid soap is going well and bar soap is not making their profit, okay, then they will make the eliminated products. It will not affect the new product. So they will continue and replace for the bar to liquid. And the next one, will the company's image be affected? They have to research, they have to make a survey to check the company's image be affected if they have giving new product sales. And finally, what will the possible competitive reaction? If they stop, they need to find the possible reaction of a competitive. The next, which we're going to say, simple and quick actions to build a customer loyalty. So based on this, they have to find the customer loyalty. So what are the things they will find? The first one, update the appearance. Once they have actions to modify the products, mean they have to update the appearance of the product's image. They can change the size and the packages, designs and all. Okay. The second one, rethink the packaging. Same, I already told the packaging designs.
they will rethink the packaging. If they are producing some kids toys or kids packaging things or eating, means they it should affect the kids, so they have to rethink the packaging. And third one, attractive and easy to use. So why it is attractive and easy, it is easy to use means the product should be in attractive, and also they have to use it as easy. Okay, then refresh any printed materials. If it is any printed materials available in this, they have to refresh that. And choose your products best quality. Yes, if they are delivering products and they have planned, means they have to deliver the best quality of products. And finally, eliminate confusion. So they have to eliminate the confusions in the products. So then market growth mix. Once they have found, they have to give the market growth mix. So these are the growth mix. C, market penetration strategy, product development strategy, product modification, it's a development strategy, and diversification strategy. So these are known as a market growth mix. Okay, so under this we gonna see first one, market penetration. So what is market penetration? It is the name given in a growth strategy where the business focuses on selling an existing products into a existing markets. So by this, there is objectives of a market penetration, and the first one is maintain or increase the market share of a current products. So this can be achieved by combination of competitive pricing strategy, advertising, sales promotion, perhaps more resources and dedicated to personal selling. And then second one is secure dominance of a growth markets. We have to secure the growth markets. Okay, third one, restructure a market. They have to restructure a market by driving out a competitors. This would require much more aggressive promotional campaign and supported by a pricing strategy designed to make a market unattractive for competitors. And finally, they have to increase the usage by existing customers. They will increase the usage by giving some offers and all. Okay, so by this, for example, they will introduce the loyalty schemes like that. So mainly, market penetration is a strategy very much about the businesses as usual. So the business is focusing on a market and product it knows well. So it is likely to have a good information on competitors, on customer needs. So it is unlikely, therefore, that this strategy will require much investment in a new market research. So this is known as market penetration. The next one is market development. So market development is a name that is given a growth strategy where the business seeks to sell its existing products into a new markets. So these are the possible ways of approaching this strategy. So which include the first one, new geographical markets. So which means it is exporting the products from a new country. So it is a new geographical, it's a places, people like that. Okay. The next one, new product dimension and packaging. So in this, it is a packaging of new products or dimensions. Then new distribution channels. So it is a distribution channel from selling e-commerce or a mail like that, some online. And finally, different pricing policies to attract the different customers to create a new market segmentation. Next we're gonna see product development and diversification. So in this, product development means it is the name that given a growth strategy where a business aims to increase introduce a new products into existing market. So this strategy may require to develop a new competencies. So this which requires a business to develop a modified product which can appeal to existing markets. So by this emphasis in a, or the strategy of a product development is particularly suitable for a business where a product needs to be differentiated in order to remain a competitive. So a successful product development strategy places the marketing emphasis. So based on this, the research and development, innovation, detailed insights into your customer needs, and being first to markets. So these are the product development and diversifications emphasis. Okay. The next one is diversification. So diversification means it is the name given that the growth strategy where a business markets new products and new markets. They will diversify the products into new product to new markets. So this is an more risky strategy because the business is moving into markets which it has little or no expensive. So this, for a business to adapt a diversification, therefore it must have a clear idea about what it expects to gain from a strategy and honest assessment of the risk. So however, for the right balance between a risk and reward, a marketing strategy of diversification can be highly rewarding. The next we're going to see product life cycle. So based on this, the product life cycle is a history of study the sale of the product. So which include when it introduced. So when it was getting a rapid acceptance, when it was on a peak of its position, when it started falling from the peak, when it disappeared. So product passes through the certain stages during this lifespan. In this product life cycle, it is mainly known as product life cycle is an attempt to recognize distinct stages. So stages in the sales history of their products. The stages which they are, we going to see introduction, growth, maturity and decline. So these are the stages of product life cycle. So according to Philip Kotler, okay, the product life cycle is an attempt to recognize the distinct stages in sales history of a products. So according to PLC, okay, PLC means product life cycle. This concerns a study of a degree of product acceptance by a market over time. So which includes a major risk, false sales of during its life. So this is the stages of product life cycle. They will make a sales versus profit. So how much they sold, how much the product original price and how much they have earned as a profit. So these are the differences in a product life cycles. So in the stages, we're going to see one by one stage, okay? The first one is introduction. So the product is introduced to the markets. So mainly in this product life cycle, the profit are low in the stage. So because the things are such a research and development production, costing, marketing costs are high. So the development and introduction cost may be also low as the way it is more quickly because they have introduced the products in a new. So it is there will be profit, they will get the profit level will be in later on. And the next one, characteristics of introduction stage. So whether it's a characteristic, it is a huge selling promotional cost or required to increase the awareness of customers. So which required to increase the awareness of customers. And then second one, price is kept high to recover high development production and marketing cost. So which is high and high development marketing cost. The third one is marketers has to tackle, means technical and production problem they have to face that. So the sale is low and increasing lower rate because they are in at a introduction stage. So in this their sale will be in low because of no advertisement, no branding. Okay, say so then there is a no competition after it's moving to the markets. If the more customers they have gained, only they will get the competitors level. So it will change in a competitors level too. Under this, the stage of two is growth stage. It is a stage of rapid market acceptance. So meaning due to the increased awareness of the product, it gets a positive response from a market. So this stage is marketed by a rapid climb in a sales. So this sales rise in the increasing rate. Profit follow the sales. So seller shifts his promotional attempts to try my brand, buy my brand, like that. So although the competition may be minimal at this stage, the cash flow improves and profits are their peak. The next one is characteristics. So characteristic mainly known as the sales increase rapidly. After that, the company can earn a maximum profit and competitors enter the market due to the attractive of profits. Then the price is reduced to attract the consumers and the distribution network is widely improved. So based on this, the necessary primary changes are made in a products and remove defects. And finally, the company earns the new segments and the new channels once they need to develop a products. Third one is maturity. So maturity stage means it is a stage marketed to slow down on sales growth. So sales continue to the rise, but the decreasing rate. By that, the competitors have entered the market and existing products. They will face the severe competition, more competitions. So by this, the sales curve is pushed downwards. So it is like an inverse U. Okay. So during this stage, for a certain period of a time, sales remains stable. The level is called saturation. Stable is saturation. Okay. So the profit also decline normally. This is the stage loss longer markets face formidable changes. In the stages, the phases they will follow, they will face means growth, stable, decline. So first one is a growth. Growth means sales growth will be starts to decline because of the saturation. They will decline, means reduce. And stable means the sales remain the stable, means saturation stage. Third one, decline. Sales now start to decline. Decline means they will start the reduce. Next we're gonna see the characteristic of maturity stage. So by this, the characteristics have sales increase at a decreasing rate, the profit starts to decline. Then marginal competitors leave the markets and customer retention is given more emphasis. So in this, product market marketing mix modifications are undertaken. The final one will decline. So this is the last stage of a product life cycle. Here sales starting decline rapidly. So this profit also start erasing. So there is a minimum profit or even little loss. So advertising selling expenses are reduced to realize some profits. So this stage is faced by only those who survived in a maturity stage. This sales drop even though prices continue to fall. So these products are extremely low at this stage, but the product or service have generated sufficient cash flow during its time. Next one is characteristics. So characteristics are mainly known as sales falls rapidly and profits fall more rapidly than sales. So in this, the product modification is adopted, which is gradually the company prefers to shift resources to the new products. There are most of the sellers withdraw from the market. The promotional expenses are reduced to realize a little profit. So this is known as a decline stage. Then marketing strategy stages of product life cycle. The same thing they need to follow. Marketing strategies for introduction stage. So it is an introduction stage is marketed with a slow growth and inner sales and a very little or no profit. So note, the product has been newly introduced and the sales volume is limited. Then the product and distribution are not given more emphasis. This basic constituents of a marketing strategies for a stage include price, promotion, both and all. Okay. In this, they will get a rapid skimming strategy. Okay. The first one is rapid skimming strategy. There are some assumptions in this, okay? This strategy introducing a new product at a high price, high promotional expenses. So this purpose of high price is to recover profit per unit as much as possible. So the high promotional expenses are aimed at convincing the market the product merit even at a high place. So this high promotion, the rate of market penetration in all, the strategy is preferred to skim the profits. So by this, the assumption is major part of the market is not aware of the product. So the consumers are ready to pay the asking price. So their possibility of the competition and the firm wants to build up and brand preferences. So this is the market is limited in a size. And the next one is slow skimming strategy. So which involves product at high price and low promotion. So the purpose of high price is to recover as gross profit as possible. So in this, low promotion keeps marketing expenses low. The combination enables the skim maximum profit from the markets. So by this, the assumption means it is a market is limited in the size and most consumers are aware of the product. So the consumers are ready to pay high price. So there is a less possibility of the competitions. Then third one is rapid penetration. So rapid penetration means the strategy consists of launching the product at a low price and low promotion. So the purpose is a faster market penetration to get a larger market share. So this marketer tries to expand market by increasing the number of buyers. So it is based on the following assumptions. So first one, market is large, market buyers are price sensitive, and there is a strong potential for a competition. And market is not much aware of the products. They need to be informed and convinced. So per unit cost can be reduced due to more production and possibly more profit at low cost. And finally, slow penetration. So slow penetration means a strategy consists of introducing a product with a low price. Okay, low level promotion. So this low price will encourage your product acceptance and low promotion can help to realize of more profits even at a low price. So these assumption of this strategy means
market is large, market is aware of the products and possibility of the competition low. And this finally, the buyers are price sensitive because the price elastic is not a promotion in elastics. The next one is marketing strategy for a growth stage. The same thing for a product life cycle, we have seen introduction, maturity, introduction, growth, maturity, saturation, decline. Same in that, it will follow like a marketing strategy, introduction stage, growth stage and all. Okay. So in this, we're going to see the growth stage means this is a stage of rapid market acceptance. The same meaning for the product life cycle. Okay. So it, which is aim is not increases awareness, but the get trial of the products and companies tries to enter new segments. So by this, there are some steps they need to follow means product qualities and features improvements, and adding new models and improving styles, entering new market segments, designing, improving, widening distribution networks, and shifting advertising and other promotional efforts for increasing product awareness. And they will reduce the price at the right time to attract the price sensitive consumers and preventing competitors to enter the market by low price and high promotional efforts. So these are the growth stage. And finally, the third one is maturity stage. Under maturity stage, it means in the stage, they have competitors have entered in the market. So there is a severe fight among them and for more market shares. The company adopts offensive aggressive marketing strategy to defeat their competitors. The following are the possible strategy are followed to do nothing. So why it is to do nothing mean it can be effective marketing strategy in the maturity stage. So in this new strategies are not formulated. The company believes it inadvisable to do nothing. So earlier or later, the decline in the sales is certain. So the marketer tries to conserve money, which can be later on invested in new profitable products. The next one is market modification. Why they need market modification means the strategy aimed at increasing the sales by raising the number of brand users. So the usage of rate per user. So this is, there are three ways to expand number of users. The first one is convert non-users into users. One, those who are not using the users product means we have to convert them as a user, and entering new market segments to introduce new places about their products and winning competitors consumers. When the other competitor consumers satisfied with our product, they will win the competitors. And finally, sales volume. Okay. So by this, it is a sales volume can be increased by increasing the usage of rate. So under this, the first one, strategy for a quality improvement. So they will make a quality improvement. In this, the product modification. The product modification means it involves improving product qualities, modifying the product characteristics. So in this first one, strategy quality improvement. So which means a quality improvement includes improving safety, efficiency, reliability, durability, speed, taste. Next one, strategy of feature improvement means they will make a feature like a size, color, weight, accessories and get up materials as so forth. Okay. So in this, they leads to convenience. So it builds a company's image as progressiveness, dynamic and leadership. So this product modification can be made at a very little expense. So it can win loyalty of a certain segments of the products. So it is also a source of free publicity and it encourages sales force and distributors. Then last one, marketing mix modification. So marketing mix modification means it is the last optional strategy in a maturity stage. So this modification marketing mix involves changing the elements. Okay, this may stimulate the sales. So company should reasonably modify one or more elements, the marketing mix. So in this marketing strategies of a decline stage. Okay, so this declines various of to manage a decline stage. The first important task to detect the poor products. They need to find the poor products, then after detecting, they need to, the company have to decide whether the poor products should be dropped or eliminated. So then some of companies formulate a special committee for the task known as product review. So by this, they will collect the review from the consumers. After that, they will confirm whether they have to eliminate or drop a products. So by this is on the basis of the report submitted by the committee, there is the suitable decisions are taken by the company. So by this class is over. We'll meet you in next class. Take care and thank you.